Out here in the dark, I'm here with my friend Tim Pinkney, of whom I am a huge fan. I've known Tim for a long time. Pumpkin Pinkney year-round, but especially this time of year. Take a look here, Tim. This was not our big pumpkin.
No, this was our only 197 pounds.
Pumpkin Junior, 200-pounder. And we're obviously going to make an alien face here. Before we get going, just real quickly, talk to me about strategy, because obviously the shape of our pumpkin plays a huge part in what we choose to make.
It was either going to be a dunce with a little pointed head, okay. Or... because we're having the Mars lander next month, I thought, well, why not have a Martian?
Okay.
And so
and you've done some homework here.
I've done homework.
Okay. I looked there. I see math. You've been doing proportions,
yes,
and stuff like that.
Yes.
This is for the front on, and then you brought this in for?
The side view, so we can get his cheekbones.
A little contour.
Okay. Yes.
I see the beautiful nose, and as we know, all aliens have a good, strong nose.
Yes.
Okay. So,
and a weak chin, so.
I want people who are watching to learn something that they can apply at home as well, plus we want to see the master at work. You're not carving, you're sculpting this pumpkin.
Yes,
okay.
And if you want to show
Let's
the three original
this.
Tools.
Because I've known you a long time. Once upon a time, these were your tools of the trade.
That's right. I still use a potato peeler, a melon ball scoop occasionally, and this is good to gouge scratches into.
Look, the old really church kinda, key, okay.
You know, watch when you do this. I mean, it gets a...
Oh, yeah. Oh! Yeah, yeah. And by the way, all this is going to be taken out so we can kind of mess around and not do too much damage. Okay, but now you've moved to a slightly more serious crafting tools.
Yes, these are green clay tools.
Okay, in fact, come over here. Yeah. I want to show you. Look what Tim has brought out. Here's the array of tools he's going to be using today. And these, that we can purchase these at a crafting store?
At a crafting store.
Okay. All right, so let's see what you're going to do.
Well, I'm going to just start off. So I've got the picture, and we basically are going to get rid of where there are not lines.
Okay.
And so... It's just like
that. Wow, you're taking it off in big swaths.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I think that's time for the camera.
Okay.
As
long
TV
as I don't cross this line,
that's
I'm good.
That's correct.
Okay, yeah, can I go over here?
Yes, you can.
It's equally working on both sides?
It's fine. You can be ambidextrous.
Oh, wait a minute.
Don't go too deep. That's your secret.
I'm stuck. Tim, I'm stuck. Oh, there we go. Look at that. I think I did go too deep. Is that okay?
Yep.
Oh, okay. He says it's okay. Yeah, but there's obviously a skill to it. Oh, there we go. Not going too deep.
Yeah.
Wow, you can take out just massive amounts with this thing. Okay, well,
we're going to take off 25 to 30 pounds.
Okay, it's probably not safe in my hands, though. All right, so let's back up, get a good look. There he is, front on. I like how we've gone with some scary teeth, because, you know,
this is Halloween.
It's Halloween, so that seems only appropriate. I'm going to take these chunks in and show my friends, and we're going to check in with you throughout the course of the morning. How long is it going to take before we get to something that's alien-esque?
Well, in 4 hours, I would love it to be alien-esque. We'll have some general shaping in.
All right.
I've only got today and tomorrow, so 8 hours. I normally take 14 hours.
Whoa, okay. We'll get as far as we can. We'll talk about some of your track record, your history, the wonderful places your pumpkins have been on display. The marvelous Tim Pumpkin Pinkney at it this morning. I'll give you your tool.
Yes, sir.
See you in a little bit.
I'll carry on.
Back into you, Maple Sy.
Nicely done. Look at that. See, Martina, you need the tools.
Yeah.